Journey with Judy.
Honest, open, transparent. It's hot.
There's no such thing as perfect people. There's no such thing as a perfect life. So come as you are, broken and scarred. Lift up your heart and be amazed and be changed by a perfect God.
It's so not my intention to start off today's show on Memorial Day weekend bawling my eyes out. And Dave, we have no tissues in here. That is a big no-no. That's okay. We'll get some. It's all good. Anyway, my heart is heavy this morning, friends, because, you know, I don't know if you're anything like me, but I spend so much time doing what I am supposed to be doing that I just don't do what I'm supposed to be doing, and that is to be so mindful every moment of all the blessings that are happening in my life, because as I think about what's going on with two of my children, they're graduating from eighth grade and high school, and I'm trying to figure out how to make plans to celebrate that time in their life. I'm thinking about the people who are affected in Oklahoma and whose kids are also graduating, and in some cases, whose children will not be. So our hearts and thoughts and prayers always go out to the brokenhearted, and we know that God ministers and draws near to those who are heartbroken. So we thank him for that, and we trust he's going to make all things for his good and his glory in that situation as well. So anyway, the kids are graduating from college and high school. And see, everyone's asking me about the party, but I am a parent who never had a party. You know why? Because my kid was always the one I was convinced who was going to be a spoiled little brat and embarrass me when they didn't get the gift they wanted, Dave. So I can honestly say that I've never had parties, like birthday parties and things like that, for my children. However, I hide behind that by having this really special tradition of taking them away overnight to a hotel, and we go swimming and we eat and talk, and just I get more information sometimes in that one evening or 24-hour period celebrating my child's birthday than I have gotten maybe in the whole month, in some cases the whole year once they became teenagers. But here's the really bad news. When I asked Carter if he still wanted to celebrate his graduation and birthday, which are within the same 3 days, that same way, going overnight to a hotel with his mom, he said absolutely not. But so needless to say, I had to plan a party. So when we talked about like where to have it and how to have it and what the party would look like, and of course, when looking at the party through my eyes, it looked very different than through my son's eyes. Luckily, my man and I were on the same page about it. But anyway, we agreed that we would have it on the main floor of our home. And the main floor of our home extends into the garage. Well, here's the gig. Okay, the really good news is I have a really big garage, okay? 5-car garage, to be exact. And I'm not bragging, I'm just saying. The more space you have, the more garbage, right? The more crap, the more stuff you don't need. It accumulates over time. And so I don't know about you, but my deal is my garage is where I put every single thing that I don't want in my house. And there's been times where I put myself out there and I put my children out there. But you put things out there that are just stopping the flow, right, of things going smoothly in your house. Like it's cluttering and it's disorganized. And so you just place it in the garage. And then so you believe, like me, out of sight, out of mind. So I got this really great idea that I was going to clean my garage. And, you know, when you do it because you want to, it has a totally different mindset, right, than when you do it because you have to. Like, it's hard to make it a get-to when you have to. But anyway, I said to my man one morning, because I don't plan these things. I just wake up and decide I'm going to do something major such as this. So I said to Bobby, baby, today I'm cleaning the garage. Well, my man knows me is a we, and we is always him. So he always says that. Who's we? Like you and the mouse in your pocket? Okay. I suggest strongly that before you encounter this type of activity, Dave, and it's really quite cumbersome and overwhelming, that you are connected as a couple, really. It would benefit you, I'm here to tell you from my own experience, when you're disconnected, which me and my man have been now for way too long. We're working on pulling things back together, but just some things that we're going through financially and relationally with our kids and transitioning, you know, we got to be mindful of the moments and mindful of that our responsibility first and foremost is to be Christ to one another and to see Christ in one another. And so I wouldn't suggest that you go clean your garage together if that's the starting point. Right, Dave? Okay, so in 10 years that we have lived in this house, I'm here to tell you that we have never cleaned the garage. My man has swept it or squeegeed it or did whatever he does. But we have never undertook, if that's a word, the whole process of cleaning the garage. So I consider this opportunity not an obstacle, but a growth opportunity. An opportunity for my man and I to work side by side to reach a goal. Okay, but my vision of how it was going to be and his vision of how it was going to be were two very opposite visions. So today we're going to share mine and my man's experience of cleaning our garage this Memorial Day weekend. You are listening to Journey with Judy right here on Lake 96.1, and we'll be back after the break. Okay, so my man definitely wanted to leave yesterday behind him as he had to revisit what it's like to work side by side with me. Okay, I'm a little intense. I'm a little high maintenance. And at the end of the day, Bob said to everyone he talked to, oh my gosh, she is a slave driver. Because you got to start something that you finish. And, you know, we always have the opportunity to do something over, but not to necessarily do it right. And my man, He has such a vision for what the garage was going to look like at the end, and so do I. So did I. But the reality was how we went from point A to point B, we were just on two opposite ends of the spectrum. So we know that a garage is where you put everything that you don't want in your house. And I'm pretty sure Bob wanted to put me back in the house for the majority of the time. And here's the other thing I do when I start these huge projects. And this is a huge project, friends. I don't care how many garages you have. It's a huge project. I tend to get really distracted. So I go on my computer and I'm on Facebook and then I'm checking my email. And now I'm downstairs cleaning out a toy cabinet. And so he just keeps saying like the me is a we and I'm doing all the work and you're just bossing me around. So anyway, here's what we know, that I'm a really super good delegator, Dave. I can tell you what to do and then I can complain that you're not doing it the way I want it done. And then my man says, I never got a crystal ball when we got married. Just tell me what you want and I will do it. So here's the gig. It's a get to when you don't have to. And this weekend we got to, but had to, clean our garage. Not this weekend, this week. So, but the reality is you don't honestly even know, Dave, what it is that you're storing in that garage or why the heck you're even storing it. I don't care if you're storing it, you're hoarding it. The fact is it's there and you don't know what or you don't know why. And for me, it makes me feel yucky just to be in that space. So I just put on those blinders, Dave, like I do in other areas of my life. When I don't want to look at something, I just pretend like if I don't look at it, it might go away, right? It might get better, even better. It might even just go away. So when I'm in it, when I'm around it, when I'm even thinking about it, it just seems to be this overwhelming situation. So I put together a list of 5,000 items that you need to know about cleaning your garage, and then I condensed it for purposes of the show to five, okay? So number one, you definitely want to set aside a lot of time to be doing this. For example, I would say a whole weekend, Dave. You know what I'm saying? You cannot be in a hurry. This is a huge undertaking. You got to set aside some time. And then you've got to get several see-through containers of various sizes, because as we know for Journey with Judy, transparency is key. We got to have a clear view on what it is we're looking at. And some things in our life require bigger containers than others. And some things just take up way more space than they should because we let them. Okay, and how about this? Number three, we make piles. That's the start of our organization process, because you got to figure out what you don't want, what you don't need, and what you don't use. And P.S., if you don't use it, lose it. Right? It's easier to evaluate things when they're separated. See, in my life, just like my garage, everything is all in and up on it and with everything else. We got to be methodical, because the more things we can place in a group, the easier it is to manage and decide the value or lack of value, importance of or lack of importance of those items. So we put some sporting goods in one section, some tools in another, some toys, did a little stuff by season, and then down to like the nitty-gritty with some screws and nails and all that little stuff. We also had in one of our piles a whole group of hand-me-down stuff that we got from other family members. See, we get things in our line of heritage that get handed down to us. And some stuff seems really valuable. And some stuff you gotta get rid of. And you know, saying goodbye is a necessary life skill. Because the fact is sometimes we can never get enough of what it is that we really don't need. And then you label it, you stack it, and you pack it. From biggest to smallest. From most used to least used. Most needed to least needed. And then just like that, you're at stage five. You're donating, discarding, selling, or storing. That's it. Simple. See, because what we donate, we know that one man's junk is another man's treasure. We know we have stuff that we got to get rid of. Because where your treasure is, there your heart will be. So this five-step process applies to our life in five areas. We got to organize and recognize relationally. Parents, children, spouses, friends. We just got to love one another as he loved us. I heard a quote the other day that said, I need to spend more time not on how I look, but how I love. And how about vocationally, that area in our life? Do we really give 100% to every opportunity that we have? Because the Word of God says all work, hard work, brings a profit of some sort. It doesn't have to be monetarily, but it will yield a profit. In this other area, financially, whether it's your saving or spending, money you borrowed, or stole in my case, whether it's your insurance or your will, this huge area of our lives that take up a financial responsibility. See, we got only not look at our needs, but others as well. And then there's the physical side of things. Dave, are you physically fit? Are you exercising, eating right? Do you get yearly checkups? Are you healthy? Are you sleeping? Are you playing? Because your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. So you best take care of it, my friend. And then we know the most important area of our life that gets cluttered and gets disorganized and allows all the other things to permeate into is our spiritual life. How's our personal prayer, our communal prayer? Because all solutions lie in this number five realm. So it sounds great and it sounds simple. But there are some things you're going to need to know before you move forward and tackle this huge project. And I'll tell you about those when we get back. You're listening to Journey with Judy right here on Lake 96.1. And thank you to Youngquist Orthodontics and Cunis Country Auto Group for sponsoring Journey with Judy. We'll be back.
Where sin runs deep, your grace is more. Grace is found, is where you are. Where you are, Lord, I am free. Holy is Christ in me.
Okay, so I realized how badly I needed the Lord when my man and I embarked on this new opportunity, a growth opportunity, I'll call it, to work side by side towards an ultimate goal that would benefit our son, we decided to clean our garage. And as we set aside the time to do it, we got a bunch of containers that we could see through. We made piles and we organized stuff. We labeled and we decided what we should keep and what we should discard. It was obvious to me that our lives needed the same type of attention, needed the same type of commitment. And I was wondering why it took so long. for us to realize that even though we remove something from sight, that it's still there. And that as much as we don't think it permeates into other areas of our life, the fact is that it does. And so we have these five areas that are key to our emotional, relational, vocational, financial, physical well-being, and they're all summed up in the most important one, which is our spiritual journey. So how do we aspire to inspire before we expire? And if you ask my kids, they'll say, who cares? Who cares about that? Who knows about that? And who is it hurting? I think we know the obvious answer to those questions is we know, and we care, and we are what ends up hurting. When we tell ourselves lies, and see, I always say about a lie, it's your lie, tell it any way you'd like. We say that we don't have time to clean up an area. Well, I certainly didn't have time yesterday, Dave, to go to the ER all day with my daughter, Kennedy. I definitely did not have time to do that. Okay, you know what? If I have extra time, I got to tell you about that experience. Don't you think, Dave? Because it was unbelievable. Anyway, we always have time to do things over, but we don't have time to do things right. The other thing we say is we can't afford to. And I'm here to tell you this morning, you can't afford not to. You can't afford to not invest in every single one of those areas of your life. Now, before you have to. When it's a get to. And see, that then we want to believe the other lie that we're just naturally disorganized. Well, see, the reality is, as people of faith, as people of God, we were created for order. And when we're not, when things are not in order, that isn't it overwhelming, Dave? It's like a burden. It's like something that you're carrying. As a matter of fact, the other day, Campbell was leaving for school, and she could barely lift her backpack. And she was all hunched over, and she said, Mom, here, feel this. And when she went to hand it to me, I almost tipped over. Now, I'm a weakling. Ask anyone in my family. They'll tell you. But the reality was she was carrying way more in that backpack than she would have ever been able to tackle, to take a look at, to engage in. But she was carrying it back and forth and back and forth into every situation and scenario. And that's what I said is, Kim, that's what I do with the situations in my life. I just bring the baggage from one place to another. And see, that omits the next lie when we want to tell ourselves it doesn't matter and it's not affecting anything, because the reality is it does matter and it's affecting everything. And when we believe it's too big to tackle and it's too overwhelming, that's another lie. You see, it's not that we can't do this. It's that we won't do it. And see, we have options. We have option. Option number one is we just agree that we're going to do it. We're going to deal with our stuff. We're going to do it ourselves, because we know that that's all we can control is our square. It's not based on somebody else's participation in the journey. Whether we do the next right thing to look at those areas of our life that are cluttered, that have accumulated far more than what they should have. And then we get to, as another option, hire a professional to assist us. Do you know that there are companies, Dave, who will come and clean your garage for you? I looked it up. But the reality is we really got to do the work ourselves. We get to seek outside experts. And you know, all that makes someone as an expert is that they've had experience in a particular area. And there's nothing wrong with doing that. Once we agree to do it, seeking some outside help. And as long as we're mindful of the fact that we can only deal with our stuff, what we brought or what we left. Because if we allow these other things to permeate into our life, it stops the flow of order. It stops the power of the Spirit working in and amongst our lives and our families. And see, once you tackle this huge endeavor, Dave, I got to tell you something. My garage now, I will never let it get to where I let it get to this time around. So now I'm guessing it's just kind of like monthly maintenance. It's something that's so much more manageable because I did the big work. We did the big work. And see, now I can invite other people into that space. I can invite my kids and make this a family affair. Let's all get organized in these five crucial areas of our life. And the incentive to me is that we're living and moving towards wholeness and wellness in every area. That's critical. And if it costs $5 to get them to participate, then you know what? There's nothing wrong with that. Okay, so just like my garage that doesn't only have cars in it, but has become a work area, a storage area, a cluttered facility for things that aren't needed, so is my life. So is your life. And we, as people of faith, are called to do life different. So let's do that. You're listening to Journey with Judy right here on Lake 96.1, and we'll be back to wrap it up after the break.
When I say your name and it's written all over my face, tell me, does it make me crazy? Well, maybe I got something that
so
I
thanks for choosing to journey with Judy this Memorial Day weekend. Let's be mindful of the moments and the memories that we get to make, because troops both past and present are guarding what it is that we tend to take so for granted. Stay tuned. Dave and who? Nancy. Nancy or
that's her name.
Dave and Nancy are next with Life Matters. This week, keep it hot, honest, open, and transparent. Peace out.